I got the trailer all connected to my truck. I was gonna use Dylan's trailer, but he actually has a lot of stuff in it right now because he's moving chops. So I just parked his back there, switched the hitches, and then I got the big old two-car trailer connected now. So I just stopped by CrossCart right now to meet up with Alessio and Carlos. Carlos saved the day with my trailer lights. They were not working, so now I have brake lights, turn signals, running lights, everything, especially in this super foggy rain. It was really, really sketchy, but they are actually putting in the motor in Alex Hilbrun's car. This is the fully refreshed motor before they end up getting another new motor, so this one can be the spare. And Alessio was cleaning up the dry sump over here, and the car's slowly coming back together, and I think they're gonna be testing in the next like week or two. This is Alessio's 330 that has like wise fab and everything. It's super, super sick, and it's his total like beater car that he really gets down with, and it, like, I kid you not, really gets down. It makes me want a BMW really, really bad. Nobody in California knows how to drive with rain. People keep getting in accidents, and it's making everything take way longer. I was supposed to be at the shop at 4, and it's 1:44 now. And I'm not gonna be there by 4, I'm gonna be there at like 5:30. Hopefully I can get in and out of there really quick and then get back to my house, drop my trailer off, and go hang out, and then start working on the FD tomorrow. That is my goal. There's literally snow on the ground, like all around me. This is seriously insane. It never snows in Southern California. I believe in like California in general, and like, this is just crazy weather for us. And like, I know it's not for other people, but I don't really ever see snow around here, so this is pretty crazy. I saw like a couple cars driving, and there's like snow piled on top and everything, and it's 36 degrees outside, and I think I have an extra sweatshirt that I'm definitely gonna have to put on because it's freezing outside right now. Like, the windows are icy. I did not really film picking up my car because it was such a rush. It was literally just me and one other guy. The guy that did the cage was actually out of town, and we were just trying to get the car loaded up. And also Jason and Justin are here. I pull up and the cars are here. They're here. So now it's time to unload this. So good thing they are here so they can help me pull it out and I can actually look at the cage.
What's up, my guys?
He's been here for 3 hours and my Wi-Fi was messed up, so he actually didn't get to...
I'm pretty butthurt. I didn't get to edit my video.
He's supposed to edit a video on my laptop, and he tried messaging me for my password, but it didn't go through. So they literally got the Wi-Fi working like 10 minutes before I got here, and it's like midnight.
But it's like 12:30.
Midnight.
It's past midnight.
Okay, 12:30. I really haven't even looked at the car yet. I like kind of peeked my head in, but was really just rushed on trying to get it inside the trailer. Is it just me, or does Justin's car kind of look like a mom car?
Yeah.
It really does, right? It's all wet from when I was pulling the car in because it was raining so much, so water poured on it from here, and then also that little, there's a little vent up there, and so obviously water was like dripping down onto like the hood and everything. We got the FD on the lift now, and you guys can kind of see the cage. We went with a little bit smaller gusset than we had before just because I wanted this A-pillar bar as close as possible, but I still wanted the gusset look. Some people don't like it, but I definitely like it. And then don't smack your f-ing lips. But as you guys can see, those door bars are super high now, and the trans tunnel. So these door bars, I wanted like a NASCAR style, but I still wanted this bar to be straight on the bottom and then just have this sweep out. So when the door's shut, it's literally touching the door, and then you have like maximum clearance for your arm, and just, you have a whole bunch of room. FD chassis are really small, so the more room you can get, the better. And then he actually notched out the door just a little bit right there so that tube could fit in there. And then also new trans tunnel, because my old one was absolute trash, and this one's way nicer, made out of aluminum. And then you can see the nice little hole for the shifter. And then back here, he made this harness bar is actually attached with this crossbar now. So he was able to move the cage back, I think like 2 inches. That's where the old spot used to be. And then this is the new spot back here, obviously. This firewall is obviously gonna be temporary, but it's just enough to get the job done for right now. because I couldn't use my old firewall with the way that this X is designed. And then he actually put a strut tower bar in between the struts so they will stop folding in and crunching and getting all destroyed. But what do you think about it, Jason? How do you think it looks?
Nothing to really say. It's a beautiful cage. Welds look good. It's super, super tucked. Tall people approve.
That all you have to say?
That's it, man. And over and out.
Over and out.
Over
and out. Yeah, overall, I am seriously excited with the car, but I'm like kind of a little bummed because there's a lot of work that I have to get done that I really don't want to do, but Jason's going to be helping me with it, so.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, he is.
No, I'm not.
100%.
No, I'm not.
If you guys want Jason to help, comment down below if you want to be in the vlogs. If you don't want to be in the vlogs, then don't say anything.
Am I a chopped liver now?
Dude, get out of here.
Justin thinks that he can just hop in the vlogs and think it's all cool.
This is the Jason and Noah
this
vlog.
This is the Jason and Noah vlog.
Yeah, he said my name first.
But yeah.
No. Fuck you. Yeah, this is the Noah and Jason vlog. Fuck out of here. Fuck out of here. This is the Noah and Jason vlog.
Noah vlog.
I'm about to throw this Black Widow carcass on your face.
I'll eat that shit.
You'll eat that shit right up. Jason will eat anything. Girls, dudes, what?
False.
No, true.
Nah, that's fucking bullshit.
One thing I want to point out is those bars right there are called anti-intrusion bars. And so that's like a very big safety where a wheel can actually push through that, like your front wheel, if you hit it on something and it can break your legs. So good thing I have those now. And that just makes me feel extra safe. And these door bars, I seriously am in love with. Like, it's gonna make me feel extra, extra safe when I'm driving the car, especially because FD chassis are a very, like, small car compared to a lot of other cars that are out there. So if someone hits my door, like, right there, then I'll be completely solid. Hoping that no one hits my door, because TJ had to buy a door for his FD, and he had to buy two of them, because the only way he could get them was from Japan. So please, if anybody is ever gonna drift with me, do not hit my door, because it'll make me very upset, because I can't afford new doors, and I don't wanna buy any doors. Look how small that little piece of shit door bar was.
Don't talk about your dick like that.
Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Bye.
I'm begging.